The IBM mainframe was a computing system that not only transformed the company that developed it, but the computer industry as a whole. Before IBM launched the System 360 family of mainframes, most computers weren't compatible. So if a business outgrew its mainframe and upgraded to a bigger model, it had to rewrite its software programs and buy new peripherals. The System 360 changed all of that. IBM President Tom Watson Jr. unveiled the System 360 line in 1964. There were six models initially, with the biggest about 50 times more powerful than the smallest.
The big bang of the System 360 was both the amazing range of computing power you could get from the simplest Model 20 IBM 360 to the top-of-the-line model, and also the peripherals that you could get.
Card readers, magnetic tape drives with 150 megabytes of storage, and disk drives were among the 44 peripherals IBM introduced that could be used on all System 360 models. And take a look at these giant cables that connected the computers. They were the USB cables of their day. The System 360 was transformative in another way, too. It was a move to one of the first ever integrated circuits. In the early 1960s, chip makers couldn't provide enough integrated circuits for a huge project like the 360. So IBM decided to make its own chips in-house. It developed a new type of chip known as the SLT, or Solid Logic Technology. The SLT modules pre-integrated the components on a ceramic substrate covered with a metal cap, each with its own part number. It was a more reliable and efficient method for producing chips. The System 360 was a $5 billion gamble for IBM, almost double the company's annual revenue at the time. The project went over budget and was behind schedule.
The costs to develop the software were grossly underestimated. It was much more difficult and labor-intensive than people thought.
But it was a risk that paid off for the company. A huge selling point for customers was that they could upgrade to a new model and run the same software as the old model. Orders flooded in.
Programs written for the first models of 360 can largely be run on the latest Z series of mainframes from IBM shipping today. That is remarkable and helped customers to protect the huge investment they had made in software and applications.
For the IDG News Service, I'm Melissa Aparicio.